you're keeping safe. I hope you're behaving yourselves. I'm ready for a little workout. I hope you are. As you can see, we're in Cricket Riviera. Got my gear ready. Got my rainbow boots. I'm wearing them today because of keeping safe, and I think it's appropriate to wear as much colour as we can. Clothing, shoes, whatever. Yeah, just be as colourful as you can. The gears we need for our workout is a mat, a rest for your neck, your ball. If you have a ball, it doesn't matter if you've got a ball, but you can buy them on Amazon, quite cheap. An overhead ball or a resistor ball. A band, resistor bands. I've got the medium today, but you can buy strong, light, and extra light. And if you do have a ring, a Pilates ring, then we'll be doing a little section with the ring as well. A little bit of history about myself before we start. I've been teaching for 38 years. 38 years. I'm 60 this year, and I've been teaching all over the show. I've been abroad in this country now for, 28 years in this country now, and I've got a fantastic classes. I love them dearly. I hope they're all keeping safe and well. From Barmouth to Dyffryn Ap Dyffry, Cricieth, all the Penllyn area. We also have a little dancer size group, which I love as well, and our pom-poms group, which I will be doing a little bit on that as well, with a little bit of pom-pomming, a little bit of dancer size. So bear with me. Also, I will be doing a Welsh video, okay, pawb? Video Cymraeg, dwi'n mynd anhofio. I'r genod chwilog a hwgiau chwilog. A hefyd, os ydych chi hoffi Cymraeg, fe na fideo Cymraeg. There will be a Welsh one. Right, so let's go. One or two little things I want you to remember. Always have water. Water is very important because you dehydrate. It doesn't mean that you have to do a HIIT exercise to sweat. We sweat with very controlled exercises as well. Make sure that you don't hold your breath. You know, I say this in class so many times, do not hold your breath. And also, if there's anything that you're under the doctor with, or if you're feeling a bit out of sorts, feeling a little bit off colour, please don't do any exercise at all in that day. Also, I will be going over, when I'm doing the exercises with you, the do's and don'ts, okay? So I'll be doing safe exercises. That's what we want. My belief at my age is that I have exercised safely. And there are two areas which are very important for safe and precision exercise, and that's the back muscles, either side of your spine, and of course strong legs and thoracic area as well. Legs comes into it, so thoracic, the shoulder blades are very important as well to give you a good balance. Now balance, as we get older, as you know, gets a little bit more rusty. But if you do have a good core, which we all work on hopefully in these videos, then our balance will be superb when we get older. And it's also very important for you youngsters as well, if you log in, it's very important for your core work to be in precision, okay? So let's get started. We're going to start off with some nice stretches. We're going to start with a lunge monkey to start with, lifting up. Now the lunge monkey just stretches that lower back. As we go down nicely, we relax and stretch that lower back. Keep your shoulders nice and relaxed. Head nice and relaxed, lifting up slowly, stretching those legs out, nice and slow. And you do that a couple of times if you're doing it at home yourselves. And then make make sure that we have a nice stretch by going down with straight legs this time. And we stretch the hamstrings. And making sure there's no bending in those knees. There is a difference between the bending of the knees and the stretch. So you feel that stretch right at the back of those legs. And then we come up very slowly, pulling your abdominal muscles up, of course. And then a nice twist. Now, as you can see, my leg is going with my arms, the same way as my arms. So we just float away nicely, stretching that back. Okay, now we're going to do a nice bend and stretch. Bend it and stretch it. Bend it and stretch it. Nice bend and stretch. And then we're going to reach out. Reaching out, extending, extending, extending out. Brilliant. Okay, let's stretch it. Nice deep breaths. Inhale, exhale. Making sure that the right arm doesn't come across. Make sure the arm is nice and straight. And then coming back. Using the torso as we go nicely to the right side. Of course, your left on yours. And then gently back to center. Let's do nice deep breaths again. Inhale, exhale into the move. That's another thing you should always do, is always exhale into a movement. Inhale to prepare, exhale as you go into a movement. Nice deep breaths from the abdominals and back to center. Down we go with the arms. Beautiful. Okay, let's do down one. And two, and three, and four. Letting go. Let it go. Let your head go as well. Just to move that lower back. Great. Okay, let's bring those feet together. Hope you like me boots. I love me boots. Love them. Okay, I feel like Dorothy. Right then, let's lift those arms in front, stretch those arms out. Now this time the palms are forward. I'm just going to have a nice twist again to prepare that back and the torso. Beautiful. Again, don't force any stretches. The worst thing you can do is force stretches, okay? Or bounce them at this moment. There's no bouncing. Nice deep breaths. Let it go into that lovely stretch. Back again. Nice deep breaths into that stretch. And love it. Down we go. Now we're going to have nice circles. Let's go five, four, three, two, one. Other way. One, two, three, four, five. And bring those arms right in front of you. Little gap for the feet now to balance. And we're going to do some slide work. So we're going to slide those shoulders. This is very, very good for people who hold tension in the neck and shoulders. Now, can you see how I'm shaking? Shake, it's not that the sun's gone in, it's just that the muscles are stretching nicely there. Yeah, so we really pull those thoracic muscles, stretching them out nicely. Let's do one more and stretch. Now I'm going to go backwards very slowly. Now I'm going to turn to show you exactly what I want you to do. Now I want you to go back nice and easy and stretch those arms, squeezing those shoulder blades. Okay, now I'm going to show you three ways of working on the thoracic. We're going to pulsate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then we're going to turn the palms out and lift and release. Lift and release. Lift and release. Lift and release. Let's go one more. And down. Then make a fist. Turn and pulsate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Coming down slowly. And now we're going to roll the shoulders round. Lovely. Let's roll the shoulders round. Make sure we don't close our legs now. Just give a little gap. Just roll it round nicely. And then we're going to roll the right, the left. the right, the left, the right, the left, and then lifting both shoulders up and push them down. Let's do one more, lift up, and of course you can do these as many times as you like if you're sitting in front of a desk. These are brilliant. Lifting up and down. Crossing that arm across the lower back, lifting the other arm up. Little bend in the elbow and a slight stretch on the neck. Ooh, I can feel that. Right into the trapezius, right into the side of that neck, and then back to the other side. Make sure that arm is across, and a little bend in the elbow as we stretch, making sure that we tilt the head to the side that the arm is bent across the lower back. And then lifting up. Okay, well, you're doing well. Let's have a little bit of marching out. Let's have a little bit of marching out here. Right, then we're going to do a little bit of balances. We're going to do a little bit of balances working on our transverse muscles. Now, the transverse muscle is very important. These are the muscles at the sides here, which connect the lower abs, which connect the lower back. So we're going to do a little bit of balance, a little bit of our transverse muscles, okay, ladies and gents, and kiddies and nanas and granddads, whoever wants to join in. Okay, hope you're nice and colourful, and I hope that some of you have got some rainbow boots. Okay, right, here we go. We're going to start off with 1 foot forward, left or right, whichever. We all get mixed up sometimes, but this is my left. So you'll be looking, so you want to start with your right if you want to work that way. Right, so we're going to make sure that we're in the center line here. So no coming forwards and no going backwards. Make sure that you're in center line. And we're going to work with no ball to start with, and we're going to work with a ball. So stretching those arms out, and we're going to open out with the right arm right back as much as we can. And let your head go as well. But balance, balance, balance. Back we go, nice and easy. Okay, now I'm gonna turn for you to see that position again. Okay, so hold it and follow that arm. Follow that arm, keep that left arm nice and straight. And follow, 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 follow. Not as easy as it looks. Then we look. Lift up, look forward, try not to take your head back, guys. That's not very good as we get older. Not very good when you're young either, really. Okay, let's go. Let's stretch those arms. Woo! Beautiful. Lovely. Now I'm going to just turn round again for you to see that movement in the front. So I'm going to lift up, nice and easy, lifting one, lifting two. Lifting three. And it's not an easy move, this, especially when we have neck and shoulder tension, but it's what we call a slide, like our hip slides. I'll show you in a minute. Whoa, that's good. And then we turn to the left as we have a nice deep stretch there, and then we go to the right. Nice deep stretch. Fantastic. Okay, let's go on to the other side. And make yourself into center line. Make sure that you lift yourselves up into a nice center line there. And we're going to lift up the arms, and we're going to follow the left arm. Follow the left arm, follow the left arm. Beautiful, as much as we can. Hold it there. And then back we go. Make sure you bend the front leg, stretch that back. Very important. Okay, I'm going to turn around again so you have a good picture of which position we want you to be in. Holding that core nice and tight. If you start stooping, you'll lose that nice corset tightness that we're going to achieve here with our transverse exercises. Lovely. Okay, are we ready? We are going to stretch up nice and strong. Keep yourself in center line, and we're going to stretch. Woo! feel it in those shoulder blades, guys. Oh, I feel it. Lots of you working from home at the moment. I'll just do this one again, facing the front. And I was just saying, lots of you are working from home at the moment, so computers are big time now again, more than ever. And this is fantastic if you can just do this. You can also do it sitting down, okay? You can also do this sitting down. And just relax those arms right down as you come down. And we go nice stretch to that left side now. Nice strong stretch. And a lovely stretch. Ooh, we can feel that. Excellent. Right, let's do some marching. Let's do some marching before we go on with the ball. So we're going to march out. We're going to march out one and two. Now, can you see my little boots? I hope you can see them. First time that I've ever worn Dr. Martin's for Pilates class. I have danced in Dr. Martin's, and of course I was an ex-dancer, okay? So I've danced in high heels as well. But this is a first for me as well. So I hope I'll be okay. I should think I'll be all right. Right then, so the first rule with your marches is keep an eye straight back, no stooping, okay? No bending the supporting leg, because if you bend the supporting leg, you put pressure on your knees, and we will be having some nice knee exercises in other videos. So we just carry on marching. Good for the bottom as well, for the glutes, max and mins, and good for the hamstring, and of course good for the heart. Cardio. Let's do another two, one, and a two. Fantastic. Okay, let's kick back. Are we ready? Kick back for 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. One more. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And strut it out. Here we go. We're going to do a little bit of pliés. We're going to do a bit of pliés now, just to stretch the inside of these legs. So we're going to lift up, and we're going to come down nicely into a sumo squat. And then we're going to lift up into a nice big reach. We ready? We're going down into that sumo squat. Lifting up. We'll do another two. Now again, not everyone is as flexy. So if you want, you can just do halfway. And I'll just do halfway. One. And lift. I'll do that one again. Okay? So we go down, roll, and lift. Let's do one more. For the more advanced, and lift. Great. Now we're going to bring our feet forward, and we're going to do a little squat. We're going to do a little squat now. What I say in class is making sure that you push onto your heels. Very important that we push onto our heels, and we lift up and down. Okay, let's do it again. And push onto your heels, lift up, and roll down. Let's do one more. No, let's do two more. Pushing onto your heels, lifting up, rolling down, and push onto your heels, and lifting up and down. What I don't want to see is this. Yeah? Or coming right forward. I want you to control that squat. So I'm going to do it sideways so you can see. Okay? And then once at the back. Right, here we go. Squats, weights distributed in the middle as we go down. Push onto your heels, push onto your heels, and up and up again. Let's do again, onto your heels. Feel those legs and lifting up nicely. Okay, let's go. I'm just going to turn around so you can see the position from the back now. All right, so legs, feet forward, and we squat down
and we push onto those heels, feeling it right into those hamstrings, into the butt, coming up slowly, stretching up. Let's do one more, pushing down towards those heels, and then lifting up and stretching. Okay guys, now I have so many levels in classes, obviously I have to please everybody, so I'm going to just do a little bit of an advanced level into this video as well. So you guys, I'm hoping that you'll know your limit. Don't be silly to try and work too much in the beginning, but to please everybody, I'll have to just do a little bit of advanced as well. So for the ladies and gents and children and grandmas, grandpas, we'll see. If you're a fit grandma, grandpa, that's fine. But we're going to go into a squat now, guys, and we're going to just go down, okay? This is quite an advanced level now. And we're going to hold this for 10 seconds. Are we ready? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now, from there, we're going to have a little jump and a little jump. And a little jump, and a little jump. Okay, you with me? So we're going to the other side now. We're gonna have a little jump, a little jump, a little jump, a little jump. And then we're gonna stretch out nicely and come down again. So we'll do that one once again. 10 seconds hold. Are we ready, guys? Let's go. And 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, shoes, 3, 2, 1. Now, we're going to jump 1, we're going to jump 2, we're going to jump 3, and forward. Now we're going to hold it, let's go the other way. And 1, and 2, and 3, and 4. Hold it, coming up slowly, and stretch it. Oh, let's bring those feet together. Beautiful. And now we're going straight into a little challenge. Let's have a little challenge of balance. Okay guys, let's do this very slowly. Now, if you've got a little bit of an issue with your balance, if you've got tinnitus or grommets or a little bit of downy day maybe, not feeling too good, make sure that you have a wall behind you, yes? Make sure that you do have that support. Try not to touch the wall, of course, but you know it's there. Okay, so the first balance is bring your left knee up and your right arm is lifted up, nice and straight. And we're gonna count 4, 5. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then we're gonna bring that leg forward and we're gonna lift the arms up. Now, we're going to turn the head very slowly to that left side. Back to center, and we're gonna turn gently to the right side, and then back to center. Okay, shall we have that on the other side? You can do this as many times as you like. You can do it a little bit in the morning to challenge, a little bit in the afternoon, a little bit in the evening, just to challenge yourselves, yeah? Okay, let's go. Make sure that you really feel that tightness into the core as we balance. Lift yourselves up from the crown, lifting your right knee up and your left arm is lifted. Make sure the supporting leg is nice and straight. Let's go 5. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Woo! Good, good. Now one side will feel much easier than the other with all of the exercises we do. For everyone, yes, everyone. Not just yourselves, not just for me, everybody's weaker on one side than the other. So we'll find that one side is much easier to balance or easier to move than the other. Right, let's lift up from the crown, guys. Let's go and turn the head to the left. Nice and easy, keep those arms nice and straight. Back to center and turn the head to the right. Oh, lovely. And then back to center. Now we bring those arms down. Beautiful. And then we roll the shoulders back. How did you do? How did you do that? Okay?
don't be too depressed if you can't do it. You know, it takes time. And as I say, if you're a bit tired or off, feeling a bit off, then, you know, balance takes a lot of time to master it. Right, cheers. I'm just going to have a little drinky poos now before we carry on. Make sure you have a drink nearby as well. Now, the bands are very, very good for muscle strength and endurance. Now, I'm just going to briefly work with the bands standing and a brief with the ball, and then we'll go down on floor. Right, so guys, remember this one with your arms in front with the band by your wrists here, and we're going to push against the band. We're going to push one and two and three and four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and a 10. And then we're going to bend those elbows nicely, and we're going to push again for 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And of course, you can do your 100s also by tightening up your corset, pushing slight against the band, and lift yourselves up as high as you can. Now, I like to bend just a little bit in the knees, just a little bit in the knees to soften. And your 100s is very good for strengthening the arms, but it also controls the corset as well. You're working on that corset. You're tightening up your corset nicely here. So you just bounce 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then turn and down. Okay? As I say, this is a brief workout with the bands, but again, we will be working more with our bands soon. Right, so the next one is placing your bands around your ankle, and we're just going to walk slightly to the right, and we're going one. You can do this without a band as well. Okay, guys, you can do it without a band as well. Make sure that you've got that deep bend, and you step one and two and three and four, touch one, two, three, four, touch, one, two, three, four, touch. Now, to achieve a stronger workout, obviously you bend more into it. So you bend, 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 touch, 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 touch. I love this one. Oh, I love it. The more you work on this one, the more you feel it into those legs, strengthening those legs nicely. Also working slightly onto the corset here as well, but definitely the butt, the booty. Oh, and my lovely rainbow boots are keeping up with me. They're brilliant, actually. They're very comfy. Very comfy. Okay, let's go higher. You can go a little bit higher now with your band. Again, you can do your squats with your bands. We will be doing quite a bit with bands. Try and get some on Amazon. They're there for you. They're not that expensive, but they're brilliant. Right, let's go. We're going 1, 2, 3, 4. Touch. 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 Now we do one more to the right again. And touch. 1. Those are my friends passing. Hello. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Touch. And that's the way. Right. So the next one. One more. Let's do it. Let's do it. Right above the knees now. Okay. So we're going to do a little bit of a 1, 2, 3 lift back down. So here we go. 1, 2, 3. So 1, down. 1, 2, 3. Bend more than halfway. 1, 2, 3. Bend more than halfway. 1, 2, 3. Bend more than halfway. That's lovely. Let's do it again. And 1. Oh, I love it. I love it. I can really feel my booty really tightening up here. And it's what we need, really, because butts are very important when we get older as well as when we're young. But when we get older, we do have a butt problem. We think we've got nice tight peaches, but yes, sometimes that's not the case. But the muscles are very important when you get older underneath all that butt to keep it nice and tight. And of course, when you've got a tight butt, then your walking uphill will be much easier. So let's do one more, and one more back. Then I can be in center. Fantastic. And stretch it. Woo! Oh, that was good. That was really good. Right then, take the band away. And we are going to go into, oh, my ball's just disappeared. Right, ball. As I say, blue ball. I love my blue ball. So does my crowd of ladies and gentlemen. They love working with the ball. Very safe, very good. Fantastic muscle strength and endurance, and it aids the neck a lot as well. If you're working out and if you haven't got strong core, then what happens is the neck takes over. Yeah, the neck takes over. So you hardly work on the abs, but you work on the neck. And this beauty helps you. Okay, in time, you'll feel the difference. You become stronger and stronger. Right, we're going to do a little bit of squeezing on the ball now. So I'm going to place our palms on that ball. If you've got a Pilates ring, just hang on one sec. If you've got a Pilates ring as well, that you can squeeze on the Pilates ring as well. Okay, so that's no problem. The ball has got a little bit more give. So if you've got a problem with your wrist, a little bit arthritis in the wrist, then the ball is safer. Okay, here we go. Let's squeeze for five. And one, and release. Two, and release. Three, and release. Four, and release. And five, and release. Excellent. Now we go down to the knees. I'm going to squeeze a little bit onto those, the ball. Sorry, I'm going to squeeze those knees onto the ball. I've done really well without pooping things at the moment. Yes, I've done really well. Okay, even though I say myself. Okay, I'm gonna squeeze on that ball. Feel the resistance on that ball. Okay, so you bring your feet closer and you squeeze on that ball. Now we're going to have a little bend in the knees, not too much. You don't want to go down there. Slight bend, and you squeeze. Okay, so you go one, two, three, four, five, six, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then you stretch and release. Now, if you're more advanced, obviously you can go up to 50. Okay, and you will feel it. If you've got a Pilates ring, then fantastic. Okay, again, you'll be working on the same area, the inner thighs, the butts. The corset also, a little bit also, works on this if you pull the corset up. So we're going in, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And release. Okay, so as I say, if you haven't got the ball, you've got the ring. If you haven't got the ring or the ball, then you can get them from Amazon. I know it's a difficult time now to get things, but I'm sure you'll find something. Even if you roll a little cushion or something and just squeeze, or muscle strength and endurance, just pretend. Sometimes you can actually, without thinking, you can work on your muscles without any apparatus, as long as you've got that mindset of squeezing. Okay, so you can still squeeze and feel. But of course, it's much better with your apparatus and your gadgets. Okay, excellent. Right, I think we'll go down on floor now. So we're going to go down on floor, nice and easy. Let's go down, and I'm just going to work this way round at the moment, and then I'll turn round, okay guys? So we're going to go round, and then I want to show you a little bit of the 100s. Now before we do this, I want to stretch. So we're going to stretch the back nice and tall. We're going to lift those arms up, and then we're going to reach right down towards those knees. Now, not towards your toes, towards your knees, so you feel the lower back nice and easy, coming up slowly. And then you stretch. It's a little gap between the toes and, of course, the feet, I should say, I'm so mesmerized about my boots. Can't get over it. They're so comfy. Right then, inhale, exhale. Let's reach out, flexing the feet. And we go as far as we can. Again, no pulsations, no bouncing, nothing at all. Just hold it there. Nice and easy, lifting up. Now we're going to bring our feet slightly together and we're going to lift as high as we can and we're going to bounce those arms up and down for the 100 section. Now we're going 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now for the more advanced, we're going down gently and we go into a nice little back drop. 4, 3, 2, 1. Slightly further down. And keep your heels down on that floor. Keep that lower back onto the floor. And back down. So those shoulder blades are just lifting up off the floor. We're lifting up halfway. Keep those tummy muscles nice and tight. Lifting up. And then start at the beginning. Okay, so we go into a more advanced as we go down. Right, we're going to bring ourselves down and we're going to lift those arms up and we're just going to go down slightly, pushing down towards the floor, vertebrae by vertebrae, lifting those arms over your head as we lift ourselves up again. Now, make sure that, I forgot to tell you this, make sure that you've got a rest underneath your neck. If you aren't comfortable with your rest, then I do allow people working with no rest underneath the neck. But what I don't want to see is hyperextension of the neck, okay? So this is what I mean by hyperextension on the neck, is this. Reach down there and you go into this, okay? And you come up into that. All right, guys? So you have a nice, comfortable position as you're going down, please. Okay, so let's go once again. Let's control it on those lower abs, going down slowly, vertebrae by vertebrae, lifting up nicely, coming up and pushing up. Beautiful. Right, from there, I'm just going to now turn round and I want to work on the lower abs section now. Now, we're going to simplify it first by just lifting the leg one and two. And you just stoop down a little bit forward. You just stoop a little bit further forwards and just lift those legs up nice and easy, one by one. Now, where do we feel here? We feel the quads and we feel the lower abs, okay? So don't force it, but if you want to advance it a little bit, we go forward. We go forward towards the knees and we stoop a little bit more forward again. So this again applies to how much you want to feel and how safe you are with this workout. Again, I would advise you keeping it simple before you go right down there, okay? You still work on the lower abs and you still work on your quads. Now we're going to go down a little bit further and this is a little bit more difficult now. So we go one and obviously you can't lift those legs as high as before because you're using more of your quads and you're using more of your ab muscles. And this is very good for the very lower abdominal muscles. Oh, so you've got your simplify one, your up to the knees, a little bit more advanced, and the very advanced one is right down there. Okay, guys? So just a nice little stretch, coming forward nicely there, and then we're going to bend those knees. Now again, I'd like you to work with your ball. If you have a ball, to just relax into this one, place the ball right by the tailbone there, so you've got a nice rest right at the back of that, right into that lower back. And we're going to do our 100s, okay? So if you've got the ball, place the ball there. And we're going to work on 100s. So we're going to go into a nice 100 move. Now, because of time, because I've got quite a few things to do with you again, I just want you to bounce for another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then lifting up. Now, if you are a little bit more of a challenge. You go back without the ball and you hold it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And again, making sure that you have those feet on the floor. Yeah, on the floor. Again, there's another way of doing this one. There is also bending the knees and lifting up into that advanced section. So we go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You can go on for as long as you like. And then of course you're stretching. You're 5, 4,